I feel sorry for everyone who didn't know Mona, because she changed my life. God used her to change me. And she was the most loyal, the most faithful friend that anyone could have. I learned intercession from her. I learned what friendship, genuine friendship, really looks like. I learned what giving looks like. She was all of these things and more, and at the same time, she's most fun of anybody in the whole world. Mona never believed that Christianity and your faith was supposed to be solemn and deadpan serious. I mean, my goodness, she thought you were supposed to laugh, have a good time. She thought you were supposed to enjoy intercession. I remember one time we were going down to Stuart, Florida to see a mother. And we had hardly pulled out of Moultrie that she rolled the window down. And she was waving her arm at the window and said, "We're going to prophesy to the wind. We're going to prophesy to the wind." And we interceded all the way to Stuart, Florida, 7.5 hours. And we laughed, we wept, but God was so in it. I think she was full of dreams. I think she had a big dream about the kingdom of God and about the people of God, that we would love God, we would serve Him with all of our hearts, and that we would minister to other people, we would give to others. And Mona was never afraid to tackle anything because she just had the kind of faith that, oh my goodness, if she could dream it, she figured God could do it. And that's what she acted on. That kind of faith. She didn't hold anything back. I mean, she was all in and all out for whatever God showed her, or whatever dream or vision He gave her. Man, she was all in. With everything she had, everything she was, everything she could be. She taught me so much about prayer. She was the most anointed intercessor I've ever known, and was praying for Afghanistan before any of us ever heard of it. And would throw herself down on the map of the world and weep and sob, and then look up and see what country was in. It was Afghanistan. And it had not appeared in the papers. Nothing was happening over there at that point. But Mona, I think Israel was just like her homeland. It was that important to her, that real to her, that significant in her life. And she fell in love with the people, she fell in love with the country, and she had no fear. She had no fear in her about anything she did for God. She had no fear of what people would say about her or what people would think about her. She had no fear of failure. I mean, failure or fear was just not part of her life or her vocabulary. She believed God for everything. From the day that Mama got saved, she wanted to go be with Jesus. She loved Him and was more in love with Jesus than any other person I've ever known in my life. And she was ready to go from that day forward. And we all used to laugh at it because she talked about that so much, how ready she was to go. Man, it wasn't a joke with her, she was serious about it. So I rejoice today that Mona is exactly where she wants to be.